Welcome to Real Love, Real Stories TV and podcast. This is Kanu and I'm the host. Join me as I explore all things love, from interviewing couples to interviewing singles and sharing tips from my perspective as a therapist and also from experts in this area. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you five relationship goals to always keep in mind or aspire to. Now, the beauty about having done this podcast since I launched it almost a year ago is that I have been learning a lot from the people that I've been talking to, mostly couples who are making their relationships work. So from each couple, you know, there are different nuggets that I pick. And so I've compiled these five goals to always aspire to based on what I've heard from my couples that I've interviewed in the past. So the five goals are: the first one is you have lives outside of each other. The second one is you should prioritize your relationship and always have fun together. The third, you should push each other and stimulate each other intellectually. The fourth is you should check in with each other and see if you're good in the area of sex. Do a check-in and see where you are. And then the last one I'm going to talk about is always be kind to each other, because after all, you're a team. So let's dive right into it. So the first point that I wanted to share with you is you have lives outside of each other. So someone once asked me, how much time should couples spend apart? And my answer to that is it depends. Now, if you are a family and you have young kids and you're busy, then maybe once a week, once every 2 weeks, once a month even might be good. Or if you're a couple where one partner travels a lot and is gone Monday through Friday and only comes home for the weekend, then maybe you don't even need to spend that much time apart, because, you know, the one partner has been home caring for the kids and maybe it's his or her turn to go out and do things outside of just caring for the kids. So you kind of have to do a temperature check and see where you are as a family and see what makes sense. Now, if you are a newly dating couple or maybe newly married couple, it can be very exciting to want to spend a lot of time with your partner. But keep in mind, it can also end up being smothering. So make sure that you're not forgetting your friends, you're not forgetting your family, that you schedule time to hang out with your friends and your family outside of your relationship. Because the idea about this is to still build your sense of identity, still continue with that sense of identity. Because when you make your identity all about this relationship, I mean, I just don't see this working out very well, because sometimes relationships end. So you want to make sure that you're keeping your identity and doing things that you like. So plug into your own personal community, which is your friends, your family, your coworkers. You know, it depends on how busy your family is. You could do a once a week thing. You could do once every 2 weeks, once a month, something that, you know, just takes your mind and let go of those domestic responsibilities for the hour, for the 2 hours, or whatever that looks like for you. And the second point I wanted to touch on is you should prioritize your relationship and have fun together. Now, I know I just got done talking about having lives outside of each other, but now that you are a unit, you should prioritize your relationship and have fun together. So, you know, date your partner. One of the couples that I interviewed talked about he always dates his wife. Like, don't stop dating your wife. So don't take your relationship for granted. Schedule date nights. If you're a busy couple, schedule date nights, especially when you have kids, you know, go to the theater, dine out. This is your chance to like get that little black dress or those nice pants and whatever nice outfit guys wear, and you can impress your partner and go out, make a reservation, go out and spend time together. And if you like exercising, here's an opportunity to take an hour or two, go hiking together, find a babysitter and just do that yourselves. Have fun. And while you are there though, I think that you should avoid having serious conversations while you're having fun. Because if the one partner is not excited about doing whatever you're doing, and then you bring up all these heavy, serious conversations, they're definitely not going to want to do it again. So make sure you just focus on having fun. Serious conversations can be had another time. This is your time to really prioritize your relationship and really have fun together without thinking about, you know, where the money is going to come for the renovations you want to do. Where is the money coming for whatever bill that's coming? This is your time to really be together and enjoy each other. And the third thing to talk about is push each other and stimulate each other intellectually. Now, a lot of people that are in relationship, when a relationship is ending, this is where they take a chance or the opportunity to revamp their lives after divorce. I mean, people lose weight. People now finally take that class. People now finally do that thing, travel this place to this place, and do all those things that they've been wanting to do. But it seems like they were in prison in a relationship and they were not doing that. So why do couples do that? While you're in a relationship, this is a chance to help each other strive towards your respective life goals. Check in with each other. Learn about what each other's life goals are and support each other. If one partner wants to lose weight, let that partner talk about it, and then the other partner can support them in achieving that goal. They want to take a class. Talk about it. Find out if that fits into your budget and find out if that fits into where you are in life together as a couple, and support each other. Be each other's cheerleaders. Honestly, you don't have to wait till you're divorced to really discover who you are. You can do this while you're in a relationship. All you have to do is talk to your partner, tell them what you're thinking. Even, you know, they might even have their own goals that they've been, you know, wanting to bring to the table, but they've been afraid or feeling like they're not being supported. Whatever the reason is, this is your chance to really get with your partner and get to know what their life goals are so that you don't have to wait to live your life until after you're divorced. And support each other, you know, stimulate each other intellectually. If one partner likes to read books, or if one partner likes to go to museums, for example, support each other. If you don't like to go to the museum and your partner likes it, it won't kill you to go there once, you know, for an hour. Learn about something. You might actually like it. So don't be closed to not supporting your partner. You know, if your partner likes to read, if they like to do a crossword puzzle, all these are like things that can stimulate you intellectually. Do the crossword puzzle together. Maybe you don't have to do them every day, but you can say, honey, on Saturday, we can sit down and do the crossword puzzle together. Just don't shut him down and say, I don't like it. But meet them halfway. Find a way that works for you to say, okay, you can do a Monday through Friday, but on Saturday and Sunday while I'm at home, we can do the crossword puzzle together. You can tell me what books you have been reading. I can share with you, you know, all these things that I've been learning, what articles I've been learning or writing. Whatever that looks like, be each other's cheerleaders, because you don't have to wait till you're divorced to really live your life. You can live your life while you're in a relationship. So the fourth point I wanted to talk about is explore where you are in terms of sex. Are you good in this area? Sex can become lackluster in relationships due to stress, due to the business of life. It's important to do a check-in. I don't know how often you should do that, once a month maybe, when you're, you know, just check in and say, are your needs being met? Ask your partner, are their needs being met? Put your cards on the table. Really talk about it. And this is an area you can get creative. There's so many books that can help you kind of spice it up a little bit, but it won't happen until you talk about it. Because this is the area where a lot of couples, one partner always ends up cheating because they are feeling like they are not satisfied in this area. But if you don't share with your partner that I'm not being satisfied in this area, then you're not doing your partner a favor. You should tell them that, you know what, I feel like we're not having it as frequent. Can we talk about what we can do so we can meet each other halfway so that you can keep your relationship healthy? Sex is a very important point, part of a relationship. So definitely do not let it become lackluster, because this is where infidelity comes into play, because their, you know, partners are not feeling satisfied. So don't let that happen to you. There's so many ways that you can explore that and spice it up. And the last point I wanted to talk about is always be kind to each other, because after all, you're team number one. So always assume good intent. Sometimes things are said, you know, and things are done, and we may take offense or feel like, you know, the person did it on purpose, but always assume good intent. You are a good couple. You are in love. You should always assume that your partner is not there to hurt you. It's always okay to say in the moment, honey, I know what you said. This is how I took it. Is that how you meant it? And give them the opportunity and hear them out as they explain to you whatever it is that they meant. Because sometimes if you hear something and you just let it stew, half the time you're not correct. So why don't you just ask the person to clarify it so that you don't assume the worst? Because assuming the worst, I don't know about you, but for me, I can spiral into this downward thing of like, oh my God, you know, he's hurting me on purpose. He's doing this, he's doing that. He's just, you know, and then you start to pick up all these little pieces of like, yep, he said this because of this, this, this. And you're just making it all, it's an assumption in your head. You know, you both should be playing the part of always having each other's back. And especially when you have kids, because what I've been told, I don't have kids myself, but I've been told that kids can pin parents against each other. So always have your partner's back, because, you know, and that's how you're kind to each other. And, you know, like I said, always assume good intent and be kind before you just say those nasty words sometimes that we're frustrated with work maybe, and you come home and you just want to like, you know, yell at everybody. Before you say that, really take a deep breath and ask yourself, is this the right thing for me to say to my partner? Am I angry at something else? And I'm just, that my partner is just here. I mean, we're all human. We get frustrated. We get disappointed. We get angry at different things in life. But our partner should not be the recipient of all those negative emotions that we're experiencing based on what, how life is happening to us. So there you go, folks. I would love to hear. I mean, I just talked about 5 points. I know there are many, many, many other, many others out there. I would like to hear what your relationship goals are. What does your relationship aspire to? What are some of the things that you do that makes your relationship work? These are the 5, like I said, that I've picked from the different couples I've interviewed. But I'm very interested in hearing from you and hearing what your relationship goals are. So send them to me and I can add them as, you know, comments to this episode. I would love to hear from you. Thank you so much for tuning in to this week's episode. I really hope that you enjoyed it. Please follow me on social media. I'm on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all under Real Love, Real Stories. And if you want to get more information about this podcast, please go to my website, realloverealstories.com. You can send your own personal story. You can read about the couples that I talk to, and you can find transcripts to all the episodes that I have published. And also, like I said, you can submit your own love story. Thank you so much. Till next time.